I blew it. I blew it.
Pirates outside, and they took everybody hostage.
It's lovely to talk to you both about Shotgun Wedding. Lenny, you have one of the coolest entrances I've ever seen.
the helicopter, yes.
You invited your ex?
It's giving Cher in Mamma Mia 2. I was so here for it.
Ah, you know, it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad at all. Made a bit of a mess, but it was a good entrance, yes.
I loved it. I'm actually getting married this year, so I was wondering if there's anything...
Would you like me to pull up in a helicopter?
Please, can you? I'll send the invites. But I was wondering if there's anything that's a big no at weddings for you guys, so I can avoid that.
I don't know. I haven't been to that many weddings lately.
Effing the best man and showing up hungover when you're supposed to do your sister's hair. That's a no.
That is a big
maid of honor.
Well, you can both come to mine, Lenny. You're invited.
Only
if you pull up in a helicopter.
Where is it?
It's London. Pencil it in October. You're there.
Okay.
Hello.
Mom, now is not the time.
I just want to ask, is that genetics or is it like Pilates?
You must get people coming up to you all the time, though, saying that one of your songs was their wedding song. Is there a song that surprised you the most that is someone's wedding song?
No, actually. They usually pick the more, romantic ones, you know.
Which ones do they normally pick? It Ain't Over Till It's Over?
No, well, that wouldn't be so good, would it?
Yeah, I guess not. So, but that's like the most romantic one in a weird way.
Yeah. Usually things like I Belong to You.
Oh, yeah.
Songs like that. I actually remember being at a restaurant once, and the people had just had their wedding and they came over to show me the video from the wedding with the song and the whole thing.
That must be emotional.
It's wonderful to be a part of people's lives.
Love.
In that way, and you have no idea, and it's an honor.
I bet. This is quite the eventful wedding. Callie, what's the craziest wedding that you've attended?
I recently went to a friend's wedding in Chicago. That was pretty crazy. Just a lot of, for some reason, the family was very performative and no one was really expecting any performances. And all of a sudden there was a microphone and it was like, this guy started singing Versace on the Floor, a cover of it at the wedding, and was doing like somersaults and backflips and all these crazy dance moves and nobody was expecting it. That was pretty cool.
I'm writing notes here. And really quickly, before they give me the rap, we've got to talk about Jennifer Coolidge, because what a lady. Lenny, what's your favorite Jennifer Coolidge story whilst working on this?
You know, Jennifer is the most unique human being. I mean, just being around her, I'm a huge fan, and which was part of the reason that I wanted to do this movie. She was nonstop, Callie, no? Nonstop.
She's nonstop. She's great. I mean, she's truly one of the most benevolent, wonderful, good-hearted, and truly funny, and...
And real.
Real, like totally real. I mean, the best. I mean, I don't know if you heard her speech last night, but I
did.
I was having dinner with Steve Coulter from the film last night. And we were sitting there in the bar and the TV was started playing her. And also we saw Jennifer, Coolidge just cross the stage and we were like, oh, she's just like, she's magic. She's magic. There's so many stories, but there's too many to even count. Every moment is magic when she's around.
I saw a TikTok today that somebody sent me where I had said to some journalist that I had a crush on her, and she told her, and she basically said that, I had my chance, that I was living, that she could throw an ice cube at me at my room. I was that close. And that I had my chance, and why didn't I take it?
You blew it. You really blew it.
I blew it.